powerful image of this service is that of the 15 candles, only 14 will ever be extinguished. And then one is hidden for a time. And then the warning, because it never fails that somebody afterwards said, I jumped almost out of my skin when that happened. There is a loud noise that is to make us think of that earthquake at the time of the resurrection. And then the Christus Factus Est, a hymn of praise to Jesus, is sung. And then that one candle is replaced on the altar. And then we leave by the light of that one candle, with the image being that the light will never, ever be defeated. It might be hidden for a time, but it will never be defeated. The service works through a series of 14 psalms. I only had the page numbers of the VAS printed for those psalms, just for the sake of the environment, for the most part. Whether the antiphon is printed in the bulletin in boldface type or not, that was a mistake. We read the antiphon together for all of them, whether it's bold or not. You'll be invited to please sit during the psalms. Always sit during the psalms. For the other readings, you may stand or sit, whichever you're most comfortable with. So let's begin with antiphon 1. Together, zeal for your house has eaten me up. The scorn of those who scorn you has fallen on me. Save me, O God, for the waters have risen up to my neck. I am sinking in deep mire, and there is no firm ground for my feet. I have come into deep waters, and the torrent washes over me. I have grown weary with my crying. My throat is inflamed. My eyes have failed from looking for my God. Those who hate me without a cause are more than the hairs of my head. My life foes who would destroy me are mighty. Must I then give back what I never stole? O God, you know my foolishness, and my faults are not hidden from you. Let not those who hope in you be put to shame through me, Lord God of hosts. Let not those who seek you be disgraced because of me, O God of Israel. Surely, for your sake, I have suffered reproach, and shame has covered my face. I have become a stranger to my own kin, an alien to my mother's children. Zeal for your house has eaten me up. The scorn of those who scorn you has fallen upon me. I humbled myself with fasting, but that was turned to my reproach. I put on sackcloth also, and became a byword among them. Those who sit at the gate murmur against me, and the drunkards make songs about me. But as for me, this is my prayer to you, at the time you have set The scorn of those who scorn you has fallen upon me. Let them draw back and be disgraced, who take pleasure in my misfortune. Be pleased, O God, to deliver me.
O Lord, make haste to help me.
Let those who seek my life be ashamed and altogether dismayed. Let those who take pleasure in my misfortune draw back and be disgraced. Let they, those who say to me, aha, and gloat over me, turn back, because they are ashamed. Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let those who love your salvation say forever, praise the Lord. But as for me, I am poor and needy. Come to me speedily, O God. You are my helper and my deliverer, O Lord. Do not tarry. Let them draw back and be disgraced, who take pleasure in my misfortune. Arise, O God, maintain my cause. O God, why have you utterly cast us off? Why is your wrath so hot against the sheep of your pasture? Remember your congregation that you purchased long ago, the tribe you redeemed to be your inheritance, and Mount Zion where you dwell. Turn your steps toward the endless ruins. The enemy has laid waste everything in your sanctuary. Your adversaries roared in their holy place. They set up their hands as tokens of victory. They were like men coming up with axes.
bitterly in the night, with tears on her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she has no one to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They have become her enemies. Gimel, Judah has gone into exile with suffering and hard servitude. She lives now among the nations and finds no resting place. Her pursuers have all overtaken her in the midst of her distress. Dalet, the roads to Zion mourn, for no one comes to the festivals. All her gates are desolate. Her priests groan, her young girls grieve, and her lot is bitter. Hey, her foes have become the masters. Her enemies prosper, because the Lord has made her suffer for the multitude of her transgressions. Her children have gone away, captives before the foe. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God. In Monte Olivetti, on the Mount of Olives, Jesus prayed to the Father.
Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation.
The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Vav, from daughter Zion has departed all her majesty. Her princes have become like stags that find no pasture. They fled without strength before the pursuer. Zion, Jerusalem remembers in the days of her affliction and wandering all the precious things that were hers in days of old. When her people fell into the hand of the foe and there was no one to help her, the foe looked on mocking over her downfall. Chet, Jerusalem sinned grievously. So she has become a mockery. All who honored her despise her. For they have seen her nakedness. She herself groans and turns her face away. Tet, her uncleanness was in her skirts. She took no thought of her future. Her downfall was appalling, with none to comfort her. O Lord, look at my affliction, for the enemy has triumphed. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God.
My soul is very sorrowful, even to the point of death.
Remain here and watch with me. Now you shall see the crowd who will surround me. You will flee, and I will go to be offered up for you.
Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hand.
You will flee, and I will go to be offered up for you.
You, enemies have stretched out their hands over all her precious things. She has even seen the nations invade her sanctuary, those whom you forbade to enter your congregation. Kaf, all her people groan as they search for bread. They trade their treasures for food to revive their strength. Look, O Lord, and see how worthless I have become. Lamed, is it nothing to you, all you who pass by? Look and see if there is any sorrow like my sorrow, which was brought upon me, which the Lord inflicted on the day of his fierce anger. Mem, from on high he sent fire. It went deep into my body. He spread a net for my feet. He turned me back. He has left me stunned, faint all day long. Nun, hand they were fastened together. They weigh on my neck, sapping my strength. The Lord handed me over to those whom I cannot withstand. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God. Ecce videmus eu. Lo, we have seen him without beauty or majesty, with no looks to attract eyes. He bore our sins and grief for us. He was wounded for our transgressions, and by his scourging we are healed. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, and by his scourging we are healed.
The kings of the earth rise up in revolt, and the princes plot together against the Lord and against his anointed. Why are the nations in an uproar?
Why
do the peoples mutter empty threats? Why do the kings of the earth rise up in revolt, and the princes plot together against the Lord and against his anointed? Let us break their yoke, they say. Let us cast off their bonds from us. He whose throne is in heaven is laughing. The Lord has them in derision. Then he speaks to them in his wrath, and his rage fills them with terror. I myself have set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. Let me announce the decree of the Lord. He said to me, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the end of the earth for your possession. You shall crush them with an iron rod, and shatter them like a piece of pottery. And now, you kings, be wise. Be warned, you rulers of the earth. Submit to the Lord with fear, and with trembling bow before him, lest he be angry and you perish, for his wrath is quickly kindled. Happy are they all who take refuge. Kings of the earth rise up in revolt, and the princes plot together against the Lord and against his anointed." Save me from the sword. My life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth. My wretched body from the horns of wild bulls. I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. They divide my garments among them. They cast lots for my clothing. False witnesses have risen up against me, and also the fools who speak masks. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom then shall I be afraid? When evildoers came upon me to eat up my flesh, it was they, my foes and my adversaries, who stumbled. Though an army should encamp against me, yet my heart shall not be afraid. And though war should rise up against me, yet will I put my trust in him. One thing have I asked of the Lord, one thing I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the fair beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he shall keep me safe in his shelter. He shall hide me in the secrecy of his dwelling, and set me high upon the rock. Even now, he lifts up my head above my enemies round about me. Therefore, I will offer in his dwelling an oblation with sounds of great gladness. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hearken to my voice, O Lord, when I call. Have mercy on me and answer me. You speak in my heart and say, seek my face. Your face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not your face from me, nor turn away your servant in displeasure. You have been my helper. Cast me not away. Do not forsake me, O God, of my salvation. Though my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will sustain me. Show me your way, O Lord. Lead me on a level path because of my enemies. Deliver me not into the hand of my adversaries, for false witnesses have risen up against me, and also those who speak malice. What if I had not believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living? O tarry and await the Lord's pleasure. Be strong, and he shall comfort your heart. Wait patiently for the Lord. False witnesses have risen up against me, and also those who speak malice.
They divide my garments among them.
They cast lots for my clothing.
A reading from the treatise of St. Augustine the Bishop on the Psalms. Hear my prayer, O God. Do not hide yourself from my petition. Listen to me and answer me. I mourn in my trial and in trouble. These are the words of one disquieted, in trouble and anxiety. He prays under much suffering, desiring to be delivered from evil. Let us now see under what evil he lies. And when he begins to speak, let us place ourselves beside him, that by sharing his tribulation we may also join in his prayer. I mourn in my trial, he says, and in trouble. When does he mourn? When he is troubled. He says, in my trial. He has in mind the wicked who caused him suffering, and he calls this suffering his trial. Do not think that the evil are in the world for no purpose, and that God makes no good use of them. Every wicked person lives either that he may be corrupted, or that through him the righteous may be tried.
Quam ad latronam,
have you come out as against a robber,
with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But now, behold, you scourge me, and lead me away to be crucified.
When they had laid hands on Jesus and were holding him, he said,
day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But now, behold, you scourge me and lead me away to be crucified.
Would that those who now test us were converted and tried with us. Yet though they continue to try us, let us not hate them. For we do not know whether any of them will persist to the end in their evil ways. And most of the time when you think you are hating your enemy, you are hating your brother without knowing it. Only the devil and his angels are shown to us in the Holy Scriptures as doomed to eternal fire. It is only their amendment that is hopeless, and against them we wage a hidden battle. For this battle the apostle arms us, saying, we are not contending against flesh and blood, that is not against human beings whom we see, but against the principalities, against the powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world. So that you may not think that demons are the rulers of heaven and earth, he says, of the darkness of this world, he says, of the world, meaning the lovers of the world, meaning the ungodly and wicked, the world of which the gospel says, and the world knew him not.
Tenebrae facti sunt. Darkness covered the whole land.
When Jesus had been crucified, and about the ninth hour, he cried with a loud voice,
my God, why have you forsaken me? And he bowed his head and handed over his spirit. Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. And he bowed his head and handed over his spirit.
For I have seen unrighteousness and strife in the city. See the glory of the cross itself. On the brow of kings that cross is now placed. The cross which enemies once mocked, its power is shown in the result. He has conquered the world not by steel, but by wood. The wood of the cross seemed a fitting object of scorn to his enemies. And standing before that wood, they wagged their heads, saying, if you are the Son of God, come down from the cross. He stretched out his hands to an unbelieving and rebellious people. If one is just who lives by faith, one who does not have faith is unrighteous. Therefore, when he says unrighteous, rebellious people. And yet, looking upon them, he said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do.
Ecce cum modo moritur.
Save me, O God, by your name. In your might, defend my cause. Hear my prayer, O God. Give ear to the words of my mouth. For the arrogant have risen up against me, and the ruthless have sought my life. Those who have no regard for God. Behold, God is my helper. It is the Lord who sustains my life. Render evil you remember no more, for they are cut off from your hands. You have laid me in the depths of the pit, in dark places, and in the abyss. Your anger weighs upon me heavily, and all your great waves overwhelm me. You have put my friends far from me, and have made me to be abhorred by them. I am in prison and cannot get free. My sight has failed me because of trouble. Lord, I have called upon you daily. I have stretched out my hands to you. Do you work wonders for the dead? Will those who have died stand up and give you thanks? Will your loving kindness be declared in the grave, your faithfulness in the land of destruction? Will your wonders be known in the dark, or your righteousness in the country where all is forgotten? But as for me, O Lord, I cry to you for help. In the morning, my prayer comes before you. Lord, why have you rejected? Why have you hidden your face from me? Ever since my youth, I have been wretched and at the point of death. I have borne your terrors with a troubled mind. Your blazing anger has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me. They surround me all day long like a flood. They encompass me on every side. My friend and my neighbor, you have put away from me. Darkness is my only companion. I have become like one who has no strength, lost among the dead.
He has made me dwell in darkness,
like the dead of long ago.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. We do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sinning. Let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. For every high priest chosen from among people is appointed to act on behalf of people in relation to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He can deal gently with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is beset with weakness. Because of this, he is bound to offer sacrifice for his own sins, as well as for those of the people.
Eram quasi agnus. I was like a trusting lamb led to the slaughter. I did not know it was against me that they devised schemes, saying, let us destroy the tree with its fruit. Let us cut him off from the land of the living. All my enemies whispered together against me and devised evil against me, saying, let us destroy the tree with its fruit. Let us cut him off from the land of the living.
And one does not take the honor upon himself, but he is called by God just as Aaron was. So also, Christ did not exalt himself to be made high priest, but was appointed by him who said to him, you are my son. This day have I begotten you. As he says also in another place, you are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to him who was able to save him from death. And he was heard for his godly fear. learned obedience through what he suffered, and having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him, being designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek.
Let him tempt me. The veil of the temple was torn in two, and the earth shook, and the thief from the cross cried out, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. The rocks were split, the tombs were opened, and many bodies of the saints who slept were raised, and the earth shook, and the thief from the cross cried out, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
But when Christ came as a high priest of the good things that are to come, then, through the greater and more perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, taking not the blood of goats and calves, but his own blood, thus securing an eternal redemption. For if the sprinkling of defiled persons with the blood of goats and bulls, with the ashes of a heifer sanctifies for the purification of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Therefore, he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance.
Sepulto Domino, when the Lord was buried, they sealed the tomb, rolling a great stone to the door of the tomb, and they stationed soldiers to guard him. The chief priests gathered before Pilate and petitioned him, and they stationed soldiers to guard him.
fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried and withered. For we consume away in your displeasure. We are afraid because of your wrathful indignation. Our iniquities you have set before you, and our sins into the light of your countenance. When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like a sigh. The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80. Yet some of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly, and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long will you tarry? Be gracious to your servants. Satisfy us by your loving kindness. So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our life. Make us glad by the measure of the days that you have affected to us,
and the years of
which we suffered adversity.
Show
your servants your works
and
your splendor
to
the future. May the graciousness of the Lord our God be upon us. Prosper the work of our hands. Prosper our handiwork. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter and opened not his mouth. They shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, for the Lord, who is without sin, is slain. Lord, hear my prayer, and in your faithfulness heed my supplications. Answer me in your righteousness. Enter not into judgment with your servant, for in your sight shall no one living be justified. For my enemy has sought my life. He has crushed me to the ground. He has made me live in dark places like those who are long dead. My spirit faints within me. My heart within me is desolate. I remember the time past. I muse upon all your deeds. I consider the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you,
my soul
gasped to you like a thirsty man. O Lord, make haste to answer me. My spirit fails me. Do not hide your face from me, or I shall be like those who go down to the pit. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for I put my trust in you. Show me the road that I must walk. Lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for I flee to you for refuge. Teach me to do what pleases you, for you are my God. Let your good spirit lead me on level ground. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake, for your righteousness' sake, bring me out of trouble. Of your goodness, destroy my enemies. Bring all my foes to naught. They shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only child. For the Lord, who is without sin, is slain. parents speak of their faithfulness to their children. You, Lord, are my Savior. I will praise you with strength and instruments all the days of my life in the house of the Lord. From the gates of hell, Lord, deliver my soul. O death, I will be your death. O grave, I will be your destruction. Psalm 150. Hallelujah. Praise God in his holy temple. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him for his excellent greatness. Praise him with the blast of the ram's horn. Praise him with lyre and harp. Praise him with timbrel and dance. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Praise him with loud clanging cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
O death,
I will be your death. O grave, I will be your destruction.
My flesh also shall rest in hope.
You will not let your holy one see corruption.
Now the women sitting at the tomb made lamentation, weeping for the Lord. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our forefathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the face of the Lord to prepare his grace, to give his people knowledge of salvation, by the forgiveness of their sins, in the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Christ Jesus, by very nature divine, did not seek for himself,
and blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight. And so you are justified when you speak, and upright in your judgment. Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, a sinner from my mother's womb. For behold, you look for truth deep within me, and will make me understand wisdom secretly. Purge me from my sin, and I shall be pure. Wash me, and I shall be clean indeed. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out my iniquities. Come in me a clean heart, O God, and renew the spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful Spirit. I shall teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness, O God of my salvation. Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Had you desired it, I would have offered sacrifice, but you take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Be favorable and gracious to Zion, and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will be pleased with the appointed sacrifices, with burnt offerings and oblations. Ben shall offer young bullocks upon your altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into